Put library district, regular board meeting, May 20th, 2015, 6:30 PM. Take the roll.
Chris is coming, I guess. Karen is on her way.
Traffic's terrible.
Yeah. Carolyn?
Here.
Morgan?
Here.
Barbara?
Here.
Linda Ryan is here, and then we have Barbara Neckens. Sorry. Here.
And Pilar.
It's the first night of filming.
I'm nervous.
Thank everyone joining the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. So this being my last meeting as a Niles Library trustee, I'd like to share what's been achieved over the last few years. We passed a no nepotism law barring trustees from hiring family and friends. We lowered taxes 4 years in a row. We lowered spending back to levels not seen since 2008. We put in place a fair private pension, no public pension burden for taxpayers. We protected children with internet filtering for nudity and pornography. We lowered fines back to olden days, 15 cents an item. We rebuilt the library on time and on budget with no new debt or new public spending. We kept costs of that down to $5.5 million from an original $12 million request, and it came out beautifully. We're also award winners of a Governmental Transparency Award for 2014 and 2015. All our books are open. We won the prestigious 4-star library award, up from 3 stars. We brought in Andrew Raylett to the Niles Public Library District, the first one to do that, to show taxpayers how to fight their high property taxes. We paid off all our debt early, and we have zero debt today. We have an annual surplus of $1.3 million. And for the first time ever, we're videoing, recording our meetings and posting them on YouTube. It's delightful. It's been an incredible string of successes with a staff so terrific that they made running the library look easy. Well done. Yet there's an enormous amount of work, much of it done behind the scenes, to make the Niles Public Library the best in the region. To all the staff and the trustees, new and old, best wishes, highest regards, and thanks for letting me serve. It's been a delight.
I, Patty Rosansky.
I, Patty Rosansky.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And I will faithfully discharge the duties
of the office of trustee.
And of the office of trustee
of the Niles Public Library District.
Of the Niles Public Library District.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability. Thank you. You need this for the next person?
I'm Tim Spadoni.
Hi, Tim Spadoni.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
Of the Office of Trustee.
Of the Office of Trustee.
Of the Niles Public Library District.
Of the Niles Public Library District.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. That's it. We can go home now.
Yeah. Not getting off any.
I am so sorry.
This is very close.
Thank you. Okay.
That's okay.
I, Linda Ryan.
I, Linda Ryan.
Do solemnly swear that I will support.
I do solemnly swear that I will support.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
Of the Office of Trustee.
Of the Office of Trustee.
Of the Niles Public Library District.
Of the Niles Public Library District.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Thank you.
And now,
I apologize, I just thought I would fade away.
No, I'm sorry, I should have made it work there. We do have a proclamation to thank you, and we have one for Chris as well. But let me read it. It says, "Resolution of the Niles Public Library District in recognition and appreciation of service by Morgan Dubiel, May 20th, 2015. Whereas Morgan Dubiel has served on the Board of Trustees of the Niles Public Library District from 2002 to 2015 and has served as the President of the Board of Trustees for 4 years of his overall service. Whereas Morgan Dubiel has always been mindful of the interests of the taxpayers of the Niles Public Library District and has worked tirelessly with the library staff to earn the Illinois Policy Institute Sunshine Award for Transparency. And whereas Morgan Dubiel has provided leadership and guidance to the Niles Public Library District during the 2013 renovation project, and in the words of Jeff Weiner, managers tell people what to do, whereas leaders will inspire them to do it, and there are a few things that go into the ability to inspire. Resolved that the Niles Public Library District formally acknowledges and extends its appreciation to Morgan Dubiel for his many years of service to the Niles Public Library District."
Thank you.
One more.
Turn this way.
That makes sense.
And we actually have a cake. That's on the honor of Lisa.
Thank you. Thank you all very, very much. Now do I fade away?
You may, or you can have a piece of cake. We could go on with the cake, or
if
you would just like to slip out
there. I'll slip out. Please enjoy the cake, everyone.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Morgan. Bye, Morgan.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you. So then we could have the cake for a little while, I guess,
yeah.
And then go on with the election of trustees. If Karen is ready to
take
over.
Does this mean we sit at the table now?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Yeah. I don't want to all presume. You should have done it every day.
This is the So Karen, you could.
Are you on the top here?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Here's a couple of
It doesn't matter.
Tell me where to go.
We're so formal, we're informal.
There you go. Okay. All right, since we have a newly constituted board now, we need to elect officers of the board now, so nominations are now in order for the office of president of the Niles Library Board. So we'll take nominations at this time. I would like to nominate Linda Ryan for president of the Niles Library Board. Are there any other nominations?
I would say, since you're VP, I nominate you to move in the president position.
Well, thank you very much, but I decline the nomination. Thank you anyway, though. Are there any other nominations? Okay. Have you accepted the nomination, Ms. Ryan?
I'll accept the nomination.
Okay. All right. All right. Then we've called a roll call.
Okay. Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Jeanette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Linda Ryan is now our new president. Should I continue on, or just?
Second to the two of you.
All right, nominations are now in order for the office of vice president.
I'd like to nominate Karen Diamond for vice president.
I will accept that. Are there any other nominations for the office of vice president? There being no further nomination, and I having accepted the nomination, I will need to take a vote. Karen, would you call a roll call?
Karen?
Yes, yes, yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Annette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Okay, so I will serve as vice president. Nominations are now in order for the order of secretary. Do you have any nominations for the office of secretary?
I would like to nominate Barb McNation. I'll accept the nomination.
Are there any other nominations? And there being no further nominations, and Barb McNation having accepted nomination, we need to take a vote. Diane?
Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Annette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, all right. Secretary is now Barbara McNation. Nominations are now in order for the office of treasurer.
I'd like to nominate Tim Spadoni.
I accept.
Are there other nominations for the office of treasurer? There being no further nominations, Mr. Spadoni having accepted the nomination, we need to take a vote. Diane, please?
Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Annette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, that concludes the election of officers. And I'd like to turn the meeting over to our new president, Linda.
Thanks. Agenda, I would like to approve minutes of April 15, 2015. Okay. B, approve the payment of the bills for operating expenses of $174,794.28. Payroll expenses of $262,575.74. And special reserve expenses of zero for total monthly expense of $437,370.02. Sorry. Approve the meeting request for Darlene Fox to attend Digipalooza in Cleveland, Ohio from August 5th through August 7th, 2015. Approve the appointment of Arianne Carey to the full-time position of Youth Services Supervisor and an annual salary of, $65,000. Okay, effective April 9th, 2015. The resignation of Madeline Bukolowski from the position of serials clerk, effective May 12th, 2015. The appointment of Annette McQuaid to the full-time position of graphic design coordinator and the annual salary of $39,000, effective June 1st, 2015. The appointment of Nicole Sankowski to the part-time position of webmaster at a rate of $20 per hour, effective June 3rd, 2015. And then, is there anything anyone would like removed from the consent agenda at all? Anyone?
Let me ask you a question. What, sure. Can we discuss some of the items? Can we ask questions on
them? Yes, sure.
I had a real quick question on the...
There needs to be a motion.
Oh.
I'll make a motion to approve those items.
Well, how do we
discuss the motions?
Right. After the motion's on the floor, we can discuss.
After we approve them?
No. While it's on the floor, but before we.
There'll be a motion made, then a second, and then there'll be a discussion about the items, and then there'll be a roll call.
Okay, thank you.
And who would like to second?
I'll second.
Okay, so the discussion, what's your question?
The Digipalooza thing? Just a real quick question on the lodging. You guys are looking at that, Digi. It says 161 times 2. Equals 322, which is correct. Then they had a total of 871. I didn't understand that.
Where's the?
We have a meeting attendance request form for general.
Right.
What is the items? The total is the 871, is the registration plus travel plus lodging for total.
For everything.
And meals for.
Ah, I got you.
Yes.
Okay. Good question, see, totally resolved.
Perfect.
Okay.
Okay, so it's end of discussion. Any other, anybody else would like to discuss any other item? No, okay, then. All right, so Diane?
Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Jeanette?
Yes.
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, is there any public comment? Anyone have any public comment?
I do.
Evo.
I'm Sue Wilsey. I'm a taxpayer in Niles, and I just want to congratulate this new board, and I look forward to seeing progress made that has really not been seen very well when I was here as an employee, and I wish you all the best of luck, and I also want to say congratulations to Sasha for doing such a great job stepping into my shoes, even probably better than me. Thank you very much.
We got that all on video, thank you.
Is there any other public comments? Okay, then we will be going to meet with Ken Kurek of Coleman Lew and Associates via Skype. We're going to go into executive session.
It's going to start in open session and then move to executive session, if that's all right?
Yeah, then we're going to have a motion.
Either way.
I'll show you.
Can we break for cake?
Yeah, what do you want? Hey, Ken? Yes, Ken, if he doesn't mind waiting.
No, I don't have him there.
Oh, okay, all right, then why don't we break for cake? That sounds great. Motion to adjourn for 10 minutes.
Second.
Thank you. All in favor? Aye.
Okay, Karen?
Here.
Carolyn?
Here.
Jeanette?
Here.
Barbara?
Here.
Patty?
Here.
Linda?
Here.
Tim?
Here.
So I would like to make a motion to go into executive session.
So move.
Wait for the purpose of.
Oh. Sorry. Motion to go into executive session to discuss the appointment, employment, compensation, discipline, performance, or dismissal of specific employees of the Niles Public Library District.
So move.
Second.
Is there any discussion? Caldwell?
Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Jeanette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Here.
Yes.
You submitted to clear the room, Ken.
Also, do which can I ask if you want to keep your
car?
You got the part with the sun.
No, I got it.
What do you do?
I got it.
Okay, good. And this one, they should.
Yeah.
So I'm going to call the meeting back to order at 8:35. Can you call the roll, please?
Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Here.
Tina?
Yes.
Barbara?
Here.
Patty?
Here.
Linda?
Tim?
Here.
Okay, I would like to obtain a motion to hire Susan Lumpke as the library director for a salary in the amount of $122,000.
I'll second it. You asking for a motion or?
I have a motion too.
Okay, so who made the motion?
Linda.
Linda did.
And then Barb seconded.
Yeah, she can.
She can, no, she can, okay. Okay, Linda and Barb is second.
Discussion.
Is there any discussion?
It's about done.
We can take a vote.
Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Tina?
Susan, I can guess you are, so I have to abstain.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Okay, treasurer's report, which Greg can give, please.
Okay, so we're 10 months into the year, we have 2 months left. I included a narrative on page 28, hitting some of the highlights. You know, as in.
Sorry, you don't have to record it, thank you for open session.
Yes.
Wasn't it recorded over here?
Yeah, but why did you do that?
I didn't want to scroll down. Record on this other small.
Thank you, Barbara.
So for the month of April 2015 and the 10 months that ended, a couple of comments. Highlights for revenue is that, you know, we continue to lag behind a little bit on property taxes. We did receive our money from the state of Illinois per capita grant. We received $71,605, same number that we received last year at this time. For the month of April in total, we collected roughly $250,000 against the budget expectation of roughly $40,000. Salaries continue to run about 9.2% under the budget. Because of the vacancies that we've had for a number of months, we'll probably end up pretty close to $280,000 by the close of the year. Library materials, we're over budget by 7% for the first 10 months of the year, or roughly $35,000. As, you know, as we've been talking about over the last several months, it's due to paying database subscriptions 1 year in advance primarily. We expect to be at budget by the end of the year. Regarding library operating expenses, Library operating expenses are running slightly over budget by $14,000 approximately. And the significant contributors to the spending profile are software licenses, in particular the new content filter, which wasn't budgeted for, and per capita grant expenditures as we spent last year's grant. And the reason that there's no budget to mention or to measure that against is because when we put the budget together, I put all of those expenditures in the last month of the year. So we should catch up by June. Regarding general administrative expenses, we're over by almost $30,000, or roughly 13.3%. And the two items that are driving this are consultants, which are roughly $67,000 over budget, and, sorry Dennis, legal fees, which are about $3,000 over budget, and we expect to be over budget between $65,000 and $75,000 at the end of the year. Employee fringe benefits are tracking pretty much along with salaries. If we don't have employees, we're not planning to pay the benefits. And on that line, we're roughly $60,000 under budget. Utilities continue to be about 20% over budget due to higher electrical costs and principally due to rate. And we expect to be approximately $20,000 over budget at the end of the year in this category. Overall, at the 10-month point, our net surplus is, well, we budgeted roughly $1 million. We have a surplus at this point of $1,700,000. And so far, the favorable result is due to the vacancies we have, partially offset by unfavorable bounce in library materials and G&A expenses, plus slower than anticipated spending on capital items. So, if there are no questions.
I just have one, and it's about the great comment. So are we attributing those higher costs due to the rates that we're paying, or is it because of just the new lighting?
It's a combination. There is a rate differential as well as a change in usage profile because of the, it's the first full year that we've had new configuration. So if you're interested, I can get you a better breakdown of that.
Well, I was just curious if it's really the lighting. Because it went from like 5,200 to some months where it's 72, 76. But if it's the rates, then there's not much we can do.
Right.
So I guess in time we'll figure out if.
And this year we've actually shot the rates out to try to find a long-term contract at lower rates.
Mm-hmm.
But that arbitrage opportunity is pretty much dried up. And the consultant that we use hasn't been able to find anything that's worth putting your name on.
Okay, I just wanted to check the right things.
Anything else?
The director's report? I just have a couple quick things. Directors or interim director's report?
Director's report?
Interim director? Okay.
I just wanted to remind the board that the library does have people walk in the July 4th parade, and we'll need to start planning a little bit who wants, if anybody wants to drive a vehicle in that, if we want to use the van, and who's going to be walking. So start thinking about if you would like to participate in that. And then the other thing I wanted to bring to your attention is a long way off. It's almost a year off, but we have a budget for it now, and that would be the Public Library Association meeting that in the past many trustees have attended. This coming time it will be in Denver, and it will be April 5th to the 9th. So if you think that you may want to attend that, please let us know so that we can add money to the trustee line of the budget to send you. I'm thinking it will probably be around $1,800 to $2,000 a piece.
I'm sorry, what is this?
The Public Library Association meeting. So it is just publicly, there's the big American Library Association meeting that is all the different kinds of libraries, like university libraries and things like that. This one is just the division that works with public libraries.
Okay.
So it's a little bit smaller, and it has a great program and lots of things to go see and lots of people to hear, and you get to network. And there usually is a trustee track of things to go to. So So start thinking about that, if that might work into your schedule.
And how long does that usually last?
It's
like a weekend, or?
It's about 4 days, and it runs through the week rather than the weekend.
Okay.
Usually go like on Tuesday and come back on Saturday.
Okay.
And that is all I have this time.
Okay, so committee reports.
I didn't have
any communication. And then committee reports. Next month, I'll probably be forming some new committees, so we'll announce the committees and we'll figure out who would like to think of maybe have another month of deciding who would like to be on this committee. So I'm not really sure yet, but I know that I would like to try to institute some committees once again. So that's committee discussion. Let's see. Special Reserve Committee, Employee Benefits, Liaison Reports.
The Fresno Library, Carolyn. Couple of things. One was there was some positive responses from the schools regarding the $500 stipend for the Battle of the Books. And then another, yes, this is a health reader,
yeah,
paper coaching or whatever the issues are that caused them to slip away.
Right.
So again, that was her idea, so that's a great idea. Then secondly, they're still under discussion about the Friends of the Library membership fees. They're considering family, and is it couples, and maybe students. They have some amounts in mind, but they haven't decided firmly. And that's about all I thought that I could share. All right, thank you.
What are the fees for?
Membership. Well, they have like one rate, and they felt like, you know, there's really a family, then there's a couple, and then there's a student. So they're giving some thought to how they should be priced.
So are they still having discussion on the 500 stipend, or are they actually
no,
vote on it?
Oh, that's done.
Yes.
The letters
oh,
went
that's
out.
Nice.
Oh, yes, yes. And I was saying some of the schools,
really
according
nice.
To her, have responded in a very positive manner. So they're
right.
excited.
Cool.
Yeah.
And how many friends are there?
Friends of the Library?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm new. Ask her.
It's
different.
Yeah, it's different here, actually. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Right.
Honestly, I don't know who, because, you know, sometimes people will not have been reminded to renew their membership, so they still are sort of friends, but not exactly.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit.
They're
rather
acquaintances.
Yes.
Okay, legislative rails, there's not. So next, secretary's report, there is none.
Linda?
Yes.
As far as the secretary's report, I understand that Chris Wall owes us like a year's worth of executive session.
I think that was...
He turned a bunch in this morning.
Oh, he did?
Yes. And
all of them?
I think there's some that he thought that you had.
I sent them to us.
Okay.
So
yeah, I have everything here. So we're all good.
Okay.
So we're all good now?
Okay. As far as we know.
Okay.
But
thank
they'll
you.
Be reviewed because it just happened today. So
oh, okay.
we'll it's definitely on our radar. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Thank
you. Thank
you for bringing that up. Okay, so the new business.
Okay, I have a proposal before you to get some supervisor training in here. We are members of the Management Association, and they're located in Downers Grove, and they periodically run something that they call Manager Boot Camp, and it's a three-day session of learning all about hiring and reviewing and disciplinary processes and all the different parts of becoming a supervisor and working with your staff. And they have, and to do that, you also have to have taken their legal issues for supervisors class. So this is a combination of those two things together to, rather than send people one at a time out to Downers Grove, to bring them actually in and get all of the supervisors trained at once. Because we haven't had any kind of group supervisory training in my time that I've been here.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a lot of very new supervisors at this point. So I thought it would be good to get everybody
mm-hmm.
on the same page, where we're all doing things in the same way and treating our staff in the same way. And then any slots that we wouldn't be using ourselves, I put it out to the other directors, and we have interest from three other libraries that are willing to send people for any seats that we have. So we would not, if, you know,
be stuck if we didn't have quite enough people.
And we've charged.
And we've charged them for that.
Yes, for air costs.
Yes, exactly.
So they're tailoring this workshop for what your needs are.
Exactly.
How many people would be attending?
A total of 15, but they would not be from here. They would probably be 10 or 11 from here, and then making up from, I think Skokie was one.
So they would help us with the cost?
They would help us with the cost. It would just be a per person cost. It's not cheap, I will acknowledge.
It was $12,000.
$12,500 for 15, so maybe.
But it's the two, it's the legal and.
Yes, it's the two trainings together.
It's three-day training, plus that they would be coming out with us in advance to work up two profiles of potential employees. And then they make up situations that you would find yourself in with an employee. It's very hands-on.
Have you heard of any other people that have used, any other libraries in the area that have used it and gave positive feedback?
They have, many people have sent people out to their boot camp, but they haven't brought them in. That's why the other libraries were pretty excited at not having to drive out to Dallas.
Cool, they have a cohort come in, it's nice.
What is the, is it a full eight-hour day or is it a six-hour day or a five-hour day?
Well, that's a good question. I don't exactly know that.
I think online it said something like 8 to 4, 9 to 4.
It's a pretty good day.
All day, yeah, it's intense.
Yeah. We'll have to time it so that everybody can get for all of the days.
Dennis, I don't know if we'll need you because it says full session legal issues, so.
Well, no.
Well, you know. Are there any other questions?
Entertain a motion to approve the proposal.
Entertain a motion to approve the proposal from the Management Association for providing their legal issues for supervisors and managers and leadership boot camp.
So moved. Second.
Is there any other discussion? Any discussion? Okay, would you like to call the roll? Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Danette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Lisa?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Okay, then I would like to make a motion to approve the purchase of circulating Kindles.
So moved.
Second. Any discussion?
Did you guys discuss this at previous board meetings, or is this something?
It's new. We have had circulating Kindles or circulating e-readers. This is for a new program that Youth Services wants to do, where they are doing book discussions where they're reading the book on the Kindles, and so that they, the idea is that they load them up with all of the Battle of the Books books and possibly some other books too, and then they let the kids pick from those books which ones they want to discuss. And the teens want to do something similar as well. They have a lot of summer reading lists, so they could load up a Kindle with a lot of the different required texts.
That's cool.
That sounds nice.
It's part of what's in the special reserve fund.
Yes.
Okay, so it would come out of the operating budget, but of that specific fund that would we transfer a million to this year.
Mm-hmm. These would be just regular Kindles that would require everything.
I don't remember what which put in the budget for. I investigated to get something durable and flexible.
Yeah, paperweights.
Thank you.
Then is there some type of a, if they lose it, some type of something
would,
that you
yes,
would sign a permission
slip?
Okay,
the parents would sign.
Okay, so they would have that all in place before they were able to
absolutely
take it up. And if
yes
not, they would have to pay a certain amount of cost.
Yes.
Okay.
But they're not super expensive, so.
Okay. And then my only other question that I had was, it says here that they were necessary accessories and initial ebook titles. So then in the future, would it just come out out of one of our line items? Because we would have to purchase and load and
right,
so,
right.
But at least the initial cost is taken by the special reserves, but
right,
the
materials going forward.
Right,
is, wait,
right. So initial ebook titles, that was pretty general. So
it's the Battle of the Books titles.
Okay, all right. Because you have like Maine South on here, I noticed.
Yeah.
Niles North, I noticed.
Yeah.
And, but, yeah, Niles West. Anyway, yeah, I was just wondering, so is that include all the high school titles or just the...
Probably not all of them, but yeah, there are...
Some and...
In that respect, you're talking about like the summer reads?
Oh, the summer reads, yes.
Exactly.
Okay. So, the books were actually sort of purchased in the new format.
They will be purchased.
Is that like when you try and check them out?
Right, you're not having to download them.
You can buy this from Amazon if you want, but you can't really...
Right, no, this would be...
Is that going to be that type of...
They're preloaded.
Preloaded.
Preloaded, no stuff. And isn't it just to clarify, can't you get one copy and it goes on six?
Yes.
Yeah.
So then after the summer reading thing is done, the books, what do we think we'll do with this?
Well, probably, I don't know what Youth Services has in mind, I don't know.
We were hoping to launch and see if this could become a quarterly program that we would... We have the winter reading club, so we'd probably start with that and do it twice a year, and then once we feel like we can roll this into chapter one and get all this switching over that we need to and the administrative roles, then we might roll that up.
Any further discussion? No? Sort of done?
Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Danette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Okay, yes.
So that'd be good for that.
All right,
That's lovely.
Any discussion on the 2015-2016 budget?
I have a short presentation. This is the first draft of the budget that we're going to be looking at. This is purposefully illegible, so I can tell you anything about it that I want to. But this page is actually included in your packages. It's page one of the budget. It's on page 58. Okay, and the important stuff is the next few slides. Okay, this is a little better. So revenue is in the budget is down 3% from the previous year's projected actual. So we have 10 months of data, and what we did was went through and grossed up all of the revenue lines and all of the expenditure lines so that we could have a reasonable representation of what the end of the year might look like. Okay, and right now, in total, it looks like the end of the year will be a surplus of somewhere between $1.2 million and $1.3 million, pretty much as we discussed during the treasurer's report. We're down nearly $1.8 million in revenue, or 22.5% from $8 million in the 2011-2012 year. That's due primarily to the elimination of debt service, the reduction of taxes of $1 million, and the further reduction of taxes of $200,000 in the most recent levy. Budget assumes that the levy won't change for the 2015 levy, but that won't be adopted until October 9th at the latest, 2015. So, we'll be coming back to the board with suggestions, and you guys will debate what the levy number should be, and then we'll pass that. That'll set the revenue. Expenditures are up nearly 15% from the previous year's projected actual. Salaries are up about $300,000 from projections due to, anticipating filling the library director position, check. The marketing and PR positions, which you approved tonight, so we'll have full year impact from that. There's also a kid space position in programming, since you, in your consent agenda, you just approved Mary Ann's movement to a permanent supervisor of that department, as well as a budget increase, a budgeted increase of 2.4% or $56,000 in salary levels. There's also an increase of 18.5% in material spending, or $115,500. This year's budget was $608,000. It looks like we're actually going to spend closer to $622,000. And the budget number for materials purchasing, the books and the databases and so forth, is $737,500. There's also an increase of 21.75% in operating expenses, roughly $75,000, due to increased software costs, programming costs of $34,000, and increased printing costs of $19,000. There's also an increase of 24% or $141,000 employee fringe benefits. Don't be alarmed, because those numbers, I don't have final numbers from our brokers on those numbers. So once I get those numbers, I expect those costs to come down. But I wanted to put something in as a placeholder. Okay? Some of our budget analytics that we look at for the general fund in particular. First line is the total general fund revenue compared to the total general fund expense right below it. And then the next line is our surplus. You can see that reading from the 2010-2011 year, we've had surpluses in the $1.3 million, $1.5 million, $1.3 million, $1.2 million possibly for this year. And we're looking at a surplus for next year of roughly $600,000. Again, we've had a reduction in the revenue line of roughly $200,000, and an increase in the expense line of roughly $400,000, which accounts for the $600,000 difference between the budget and the projected actuals. The last little bit of the slide has to do with our fund balance. We started the year with about $6.3 million in ending fund balance. We expect to have about $1.2 million in surplus, but we transferred $1.2 million to the special reserve fund during the year. So we'll end up the year, I'm projecting we'll end up the year with about the $6.3 million fund balance in the general fund. If the proposed budget numbers hold at the end of next year, we should be closer to $7 million. The last line shows the fund balance as a percentage of expenditures. So what it kind of tells you is how much dry powder we have if the revenue line stops, for whatever reason. If you remember a few years ago, they delayed the real estate tax bills, the second installment, and that put a strain on a lot of public entities like us. But since we have money in the bank, so to speak, and that we have a healthy fund balance, we would be able to weather that storm without having to go to the market for tax anticipation warrants or anything, any outside borrowing. So the general fund revenue expenditure increase results in a surplus of about $600,000. You saw that. the resulting fund balance will be flat when compared to last year, and then will be at about $7 million at the end of 2016. We're still waiting for results of the matrix study, which may have an impact on staffing in the anticipated budget. We haven't made any drastic movements or anything like that in personnel or organization or anything of that nature. We're waiting for that last bit of information to help us do that. We're waiting for a finalized bid for employee insurance. We do know it's going to go up because that's the nature of it, unfortunately. The question is, you know, how much, and more importantly, what the price tags will look like, that employees will pay for that coverage. I fully expect that if the cost goes up, that the price tags will go up an equal amount if we're going to maintain the same ratios that we have in the past. And then also waiting for a finalized bid for property and casualty insurance. Right now, our brokers are forecasting about a 3% decrease, but it's a relatively small amount. That it's about a $50,000 cost of for all of those insurances together. Important things to note: these are preliminary; they will change based on some of the factors. And as each month passes, we get smarter about what we might have missed in the first draft, but we'll show you what those changes are as we make them. The budget deadline for adoption is the fourth Tuesday of September, or September 22nd. By comparison, the last 2 years we adopted the budget at the August meeting, August 20th and August 21st. And that's it. Oh, sorry.
Thank you.
So, if there are any questions, I'd be happy to answer them. I know it's a lot to take in, but what we've provided is a summary sheet, detailed general fund revenue analysis on page 59, on pages 60 and 61, you can see detailed line-by-line expenditures. There's trend information, again, going back from 2010, 2011, all the way up through 2014. Those numbers to the left of the shaded columns have all been audited and tied back to our audit reports. The projected actual, those are my numbers, my best guess in terms of what the year is going to look like at June 30th. Compared to the current annual budget, and then what the proposed budget is for the 2015-2016. Now that I'm reading it, I apologize. I missed some date changes at the head of the columns. So the rightmost column over proposed budget should read 2015-2016. Oh. And then the shaded columns, should be 2014-2015. I apologize for that. I think I caught them everywhere else, but here.
Sure.
And that was the page that you had me
wrong. Yeah, sorry. Sorry, I wish you called.
This one, 14-15.
Yeah, this is 14-15, and then this one is 14-16.
Okay, so the one that says 13-14 is 14-15.
Yeah,
that's what I thought.
On page 62 is basically a roll forward of our special revenue funds. To remind everybody, we have separate funds for specialized expenses. We have six of them: audit, liability insurance, Social Security, workers' compensation, unemployment compensation, building and site. All of those funds when I started working for the library, summed to approximately $1,150,000, and we've been purposefully working them down so that we're not carrying a large fund balance. We'd rather carry a fund balance in the general fund than warehouse money in here, because once it enters a special revenue fund, it can only be spent for that specific purpose. It doesn't library no good anywhere else. So if you read along the bottom line, it says projected fund balance for 2016, June 30th. Some of the funds are still pretty big, like the liability insurance fund. Some of them are pretty small, like the workers' compensation fund. And as a matter of fact, the next two lines show, you know, just based on regular run rate, when do you expect those funds to run out of money? And when those funds run out of money, it's not time to panic as much as it's time to consider changing the tax levy so that we can make sure that those, you know, that the right amount of money is going into those funds. And we could talk about that, you know, when we talk about the tax levy in the fall. So, unless there's anything else.
No, I think I just want to say, I had told you I thought that we would do, that this would be the preliminary and next month would be the final. That would be optimistic, obviously. So we will have many more chances to lose.
So next month we'll have a couple of motions, just like we did last year. One will be to approve the property casualty insurance contracts, which should be in the $50,000 range. And then the other one will be to approve the health insurance renewals along with some of the other smaller insurance renewals. And that'll be more significant. You know, that should be in the, you know, $450,000 range. Once those are completed, then I could roll those final numbers into the budget, and the budget will have, you know, much more realistic looking feel to it.
So I would like to make a motion to discuss the change to board meetings start time from 6:30 to 7.
I'm sorry, that. But wait a minute, this is a motion to change, not just to discuss, right?
Well, motion to for discussion.
No, you didn't have a discussion with them.
Oh, so we should have a discussion first.
Well.
Discussion.
Yeah, because we don't have it on as
okay.
Final action.
So oh, okay.
Let's have
so
a discussion
okay.
About it, and then if you want to change,
still
we'll
learning.
Change
okay. When did this idea come up? Well,
I was thinking about running.
Oh,
there you go.
It's hard for Tim to get here at the time, and I had said it used to be 7. He's like, oh, and then there was. And then also Karen, it's really difficult.
Yeah.
She's always
running.
Yes,
I'm down.
You know,
I'm always
running at the last minute.
You know, and that was kind of another idea of having committees. Maybe we can get some of the preliminary work done at other times, and then our meetings possibly won't run as long. You know, so it could actually work and still not really be a time issue, hopefully. So, just out of consideration, since we're all volunteers.
Yeah, I generally don't get home till around 6:15.
Okay, well, that's fine.
But, you know, I don't want it to be about me.
So,
yes, I do.
What do other people think?
That's fine.
Yeah, I personally have no problem with it.
I think it's fine.
I get home at 5:30. I get home at 4.
5:30 would be a better time.
Yes.
Home
at 3:30,
but 6:07.
But
I have one question.
Yeah.
How does it affect Greg or Susan who are here all day?
Okay.
Okay.
Hopefully it won't. Hopefully
it'll
still
be quick.
Pretty consistent.
Yeah. There you go.
I mean, 6:45. Okay, or is it still 7 would be best? 7 would be best.
She's
just throwing it out there, discussion.
Yeah.
Throwing?
Yeah. 7 is fine.
Okay.
You're an electrical youth, the clock.
Okay.
Especially as the weather gets bad in the winter.
Oh, God, yes, when you've got the snow to contend with.
That's when I won't want to come out of the house.
Yeah.
Once I get home, I won't want to go out.
Make it go on the agenda for next month.
So next month, we will be at 6:30, right?
Yes.
Next month, will still be 6:30?
We can't decide tonight.
It was just a discussion.
Oh, okay. It's on the agenda.
It's my election.
Right.
We discussed.
Good.
Unfinished business, discussion of Freedom From Religion Foundation request.
This is the letter that we received, right?
Right.
Yes.
I think this is like the second letter we received from this organization, I think, is that right?
My understanding is that Morgan reached out to the organization, and he passed a letter out at a board meeting 2-3 months ago. And then I believe that the leader of this organization contacted each of you individually.
Probably.
If you haven't been able to get into your Niles Library email, you may not have actually had access to this.
How old is it?
I didn't know anything about it, because he did not address it to me, so I didn't know anything about it until last month's meeting, when one of you mentioned it.
I did have one email.
So then, so I just thought, since it asks for you to think about it, I thought it should probably go on the agenda to be considered.
There's an interesting article in the Journal today about it. Your copies of it, it made the journal.
Well, we even talked about it.
Well, I see what she, go ahead, I'm sorry. I was going to say, I see this person is local, they're from Niles. I've never heard of the FFRF. But it's obviously been brought up in her letter, or is it a mail? Sam, okay. In his letter, he poses the question, is the public library acting as an official sponsor and providing taxpayer funds, such as the use of library resources to help promote an event that assists in the fundraising toward advancement of a religious institution? Now, the answer is definitely no. And of course, we have an attorney here, but there are some cases in, you know, the First Amendment Establishment Clause does sort of explain what in fact respecting an establishment of religion means, and we don't really fall under this. We are not promoting religion, and this particular letter is about some of us attending the gala dinner at St. John Briba. Now, the library paid for us to attend a dinner, and the dinner in no way promotes the furthering of Catholic religion. It also states here that in the First Amendment, it says, I'll read the whole thing. The First Amendment Establishment Clause prohibits the government from making any law respecting an establishment of religion. This clause not only forbids the government from establishing an official religion, but also prohibits government action that unduly favor one religion over another. It also prohibits the government from unduly preferring religion over non-religion or non-religion over religion. I think in this paragraph, we can compare having dinner at St. John Briba and supporting, or not supporting, but recognizing the students at that school who come to this library for the same reasons that we had dinner at, was it 63, whose students are also attendees in the library and participate in the programs. So we were in, so the only violation here is that this person thinks we are promoting religion, and we're not. We attended a dinner. If people participated in the fundraising for the school, that was all personal money. So I don't see how we are actually in violation of anything.
Yeah, I actually think we were supporting the St. John Briba, anyone who went, and their ticket was paid for by public funds. So the school district, the library did pay four tickets, And I understand it was a fundraiser. It wasn't just the cost of the dinner that the library was paying for. I think it's the nature of fundraiser.
No, that's not true. It's just for the dinner. The fundraiser was all the bedding and...
Well, I'm sure that's additional fundraising. Mm-hmm. But I think they raised money as a I think it's called a fundraiser. Mm-hmm. And so we are, in fact, raising funds, or the taxpayers are raising funds for a private institution. So I actually think that this letter writer has a good point here, and that we probably should not be buying tickets or financially supporting in any way any religious institutions. And I will actually go further, and I think that there is a difference when we buy tickets to District 63 or the school district because they're public institutions. But I will even say that I think probably we should stop doing that too. Not that, you know, I don't like District 63 Foundation, but I think if individual trustees want to go to events and, you know, say I'm here and I'm a trustee and I support you, that's fine. But I don't think that the library should be paying for it. I think that we should pay for our own tickets if we go to any event. And that particularly religious organization events, but any events.
And that's a fair assumption, but I still think we should clarify whether or not we are supporting a religious, whether, I don't think it was a fundraiser, and that's the part I'm a bit upset about.
Actually, I think you're wrong about that. A portion of the dinner ticket does go to fund the school.
Okay, and then there's other legislation or other court cases that indicate funding the school doesn't necessarily mean funding religion. I mean, wasn't the big draw that night for technology or laptops for the kids? So, I mean, I think...
It's obviously furthering the Catholic education for that school. And I'm a pro-Gaelic, but...
Yeah, and I've worked it several years as well. But if that's your perception, then that's important.
Well, part of that ticket is fundraising money.
But isn't then 63 is the same thing? That's a fundraiser too. So.
But it's not a religion.
It's the public schools.
I'm not understanding.
They don't teach any religious classes at District 63.
Well, no, I understand that part, but that's because
church and state.
Yeah. I mean, you know, Catholic school tuition's high. There's probably a slew of Catholics in that school. The parents just can't afford to send them to the Catholic school. So it's the same. It's still a fundraiser, is what I'm saying.
Working for a public school, we are not allowed to speak anything about Christ.
Oh, right. I know
Catholic,
that.
Catholic.
Right. I know that.
Buddhist, whatever. We are not allowed to teach that or talk about it, really.
Right.
If the kids bring it up, they answer simple questions, but we're not allowed to talk about it.
Right.
So saying a public school is like a Catholic school, I would have to disagree.
No, I'm not saying it's like a cat at all.
Okay. I'm sorry, I misunderstood what you were saying.
Absolutely not. No. I'm just saying, I guess in general, it's St. John's a fundraiser, District 63 is a fundraiser, so we're still supporting both schools. So, like Karen said, then we shouldn't really attend at all.
And I agree with that.
It's a larger
discussion. Or if we attend, pay it ourselves.
Right.
Now, I had a wacky idea.
Okay.
I'm going to throw this out. And it's probably like really dumb. But is it possible to create a little special fund that accepts donations and then from that fund pay for the tickets so that we are not using taxpayer funds, but we are still supporting these organizations?
Right, yes, as long as it's not taxpayer dollars.
Well, so the funds in the library actually accepts donations.
Right.
So, I mean, if anyone was going to make a donation, they could make friends. I don't know if friends wants to buy us tickets to the
country. It's just a thought.
I'm not sure.
Okay. Sure. They don't know. All right. You know, it's just
something
we
to
could.
Consider.
We could, because I'm really in favor of supporting these schools and the organizations in whatever manner we can. But I see the letter of the law here. But if there's a way to circumvent or, you know, do both activities without being violation, that would be great.
And it doesn't mean that we can't mark it or we can't talk about it, but, you know, post, as long as we posted everyone's, but you wouldn't want to.
Yeah, and I suppose also there's a possibility of it sort of snowballing too. Even if we confine it to public schools, part of our district's in District 61, part of our library district's in 64, part of it, I don't know if it's in.
Maybe 62.
60, I don't know.
Maybe
62,
a little baby.
62. I mean, so if all those foundations, I imagine each one of them has a foundation,
sure.
If they all started asking us to come, you know. And then, you know, there's the chamber dinner too.
Absolutely. The question is, where does it stop?
Well,
and how, and it's
that's
arbitrary.
It. That's it. And, you know,
right.
How can we say, well, we're going to support one,
right,
but
right.
Another?
Golf outings,
so,
all
well,
kinds of stuff.
And my concern is trying to be not Miss Frugal that I am known to be quite often. Realistically, yeah, it's going to snowball. And how much of the taxpayer money are we not spending technically on the library? And we're talking about the library, some of our things going up. Shouldn't our money be going there instead of to us going to things? I mean, granted, there are things that are related to the library, such as the educational thing she was talking about earlier. But, you know, it's kind of, it can be a big, you know.
It's important for us to make connections and be connected with our community.
Absolutely.
You know, but I think this is a really valid discussion. I think we really should continue it.
Absolutely.
And figure out where we can have a balance or, I don't know, I think it's just it has to be a tabled discussion and continue to be discussed because we obviously have some difference of opinions and maybe we can actually create a policy eventually and put it in writing.
I was a constituent called me on this and he was very concerned that we weren't supporting the schools. And I somewhere in here someone talks about how many times the schools were visited.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And I think mm-hmm. that's something, and he was completely unaware of that.
Yeah.
So I think that's something that we need to publicize and promote so that the general population knows how much we are supporting schools regardless of their affiliations.
That's
right.
A good point.
And
right.
That is a good point because I know they, you know, the teen librarian came to Maine South during National Library Week
right.
and
right.
gave all their, actually a couple of our students actually won poetry contests.
Yep.
You know,
yep.
And
so
I mean, really, and getting their, you know, the kids to know our teen librarians and, you know, the programs, that face-to-face, it
absolutely.
All, and they're doing it all the time. So yeah, that's the key.
And it's a perception.
That's the key.
It's a perception. And he felt we weren't supporting, but I said it straight.
That's a great point, and we will definitely follow up on that.
So,
yeah, it really is.
Won't be calling me.
Then you
lost that
number, huh?
Yeah.
Look at this. You. okay.
So are we responding to this fellow? Because if they do say we're looking forward to hearing.
We're just discussing.
Okay.
We've got a few of these letters.
Okay. Very nice.
And any unfinished business? Oh, that was our unfinished business. Anything other? Discussion of viewing short takes for trustee videos.
Let me just very quickly sum up that on the Rails website, they have a series of videos that you can go to that are on different topics pertaining to being a library trustee that's put out by the library trustee arm of the American Library Association. And they each one of them lasts 5 to 10 minutes. And I was considering if we should put it on the agenda, but since, I mean, obviously not tonight, but I don't know. I'll just throw it out there and you can think about it. And I'll follow up with some more specifics by email.
Great, great.
Are we
all on board with the email, the library email system? Right. I've been getting my emails.
I'm not sure.
Yeah,
if
I've viewed it.
Good. We're all. Got
you. Got
well,
you
anyone did. That needs help can get assistance from our IT department. They're very good at troubleshooting. So.
Okay.
So, I'm motion to adjourn.
Did Patty second?
Oh, Carolyn did.
Carolyn.
I was wrong, I apologize.
Okay, Karen?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Jeanette?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Yes.